Alright, welcome back everyone. I wanted to do a video on a pool bucket filter. This is intended to be a quick way to clear up brown pool water, making it crystal clear. This works for pools filled with well water or water with lots of iron or other metals in it. You'll know because the water looks brown or yellowish, maybe even orange. If it's a bright green, that's very likely an algae issue. So, as some background, we took a sample of our pool water to the pool store and the guy ran his tests and said, "Your water is perfect." And we're like, "But it's brown." He said, "It's iron and other metals from your well water." Okay, but the water was clear when we put it in. So it turns out that naturally occurring iron in your water reacts with the chlorine and oxygen to form literal rust in the water, and that's what you're seeing. You can get rid of the brown by setting up a Polyfill Bucket pool filter. I know what you're thinking. Isn't that what our actual pool filter's supposed to do? Well, you're right, but a typical sand filter won't capture particles smaller than about 20 microns. Most of these rust particles are smaller than that. So that's when I decided to try out a Polyfill bucket filter, and to my surprise, it actually worked. Now, I want to say this up front. For my 18-foot pool, it didn't happen overnight, but after a week and a half, the water was actually clear. I can only assume this would be faster for smaller pools. Alright, so here's how I built it. I've seen more complicated designs that may work better, but I wanted this to be as simple as possible. I didn't want to construct a support system, drill holes, or add fittings, or that sort of thing. Most of the parts here are things you may already have lying around. Okay, so here's what you'll need. A 5-gallon bucket, a sump pump, a 16-ounce bag of polyfill, a bungee cord, some netting, and a few large stones. I'll put links to some of this stuff in the video description. This schematic shows the way this thing works. The brown pool water is sucked through the polyfill filter material by the sump pump. Then the clean water is pumped back out into the pool. Eventually, all the rust gets filtered out of the water. So let's construct the bucket filter. I start by adding several large stones to the bottom, just because I noticed that some of the grit would settle to the bottom of the bucket and I don't want to recirculate that. It also helps keep the polyfill from getting sucked into the pump as well. Next, put the sump pump on top of the rocks. Then, pack the polyfill around it, all the way to the top of the bucket. Next, you'll need some type of lid. I chose to use some flexible garden netting. This allowed for easier accommodation of the cord and the outlet tube of the pump. I put a bungee cord around the lid to hold it on. And that's it. Now, lower the bucket into your pool. Make sure the cord is dry and safe, then plug it in. This particular sump pump pumps 1,500 gallons per hour. An 18-foot pool holds about 7,600 gallons. So if this is run continuously, it will achieve about 4 turnovers per day. Of course, there will be a lot of recirculation. Okay, so here are the results. I put my camera underwater so that you can more clearly see the effect. So here is when I first started. The water is quite brown. And here's after the first day. I emptied the bucket about once a day, And here are the results of what is left in the bottom after one day of filtering. It's actually pretty remarkable how much crud this filters out. I poured out the bucket and rinsed the polyfill with a hose. I reused the polyfill throughout the course of this test. Then I put the bucket filter back together and back into the pool. Here's the result after 2 days. The filtered out water is still brown. And the results after 3 days, still quite dirty. The results after 4 days. The results after 5 days. The results after 6 days. Here we're starting to see some improvement. And the results after 7 days. Here I had switched from the sump pump hose to a larger diameter PVC pipe for the water outlet from the pump. This allowed for increased water flow and I think helped clean the water faster. Here are the results after 8 days. After 9 days. And finally, after 10 days of filtering. From here, just keeping up with the chlorine kept the pool nice and clear. Alright, so here is a quick summary showing the cleanup from day to day. Day 1. Day 2. Day 3. Day 7. Day 8. Day 9. And day 10. I hope this video is helpful for those of you who use well water or iron-rich water to fill your pool. Thanks for watching and all the best.